are very less. I think in my GATE score, I got 17 out of 17,000 people. That's how it was. And initially, I worked in General Motors, after that, Microsoft, and now currently in Qualcomm as a Phoenix application engineer. So why I am enforcing my introduction is because I am also like you. I started my education as a diploma engineer and then bachelor's. After that, I got a job in Bombay with very less salary, so that I thought it is better to go for Bangalore instead of Bombay as a campus placement. And then after that, I worked for 1 year, and then I started preparing for GATE, because obviously your dream is somewhere and you are working in different locations, then you are not going to be satisfied. Okay, so coming to courses and careers, mostly we are going to focus on what kind of courses which are very good in the present trend, and even traditional courses which are available for the electrical and electronics engineering background students. And careers based on your course, the careers will be different. Can you go to the next slide, sir? So this is the agenda of today's class. Cut-off scores, so only one or two IITs are presented, and the remaining will follow as is. And courses, which are the good courses, or which are the courses available for practical students. And careers, so the career options which are available as of now in the industry, and the companies which are offering jobs based on your career. Of course. So here are the cutoff scores. So basically, I started with IIT Bombay because I studied there. That is only the motivation. And IIT Bombay offers very good courses. So when you compare control and computing, that is one of the course, power electronics and power systems, electronic systems, energy systems, and control and instrumentation. First three courses are offered by electrical engineering department. Apart from these three courses, there are microelectronics is also there. But microelectronics, I am not suggesting electrical people to go for microelectronics because of inherent difficulty, because we are not much focused in engineering as it was electronics. And energy systems is a separate department in IIT Bombay, and control and instrumentation is a one more interdisciplinary course. Here are the last year cutoff ranges. Control and computing, so they can call for exam from 400 to 525, but you are going to get more chances if your score is in the range of 500 to 525. And second one is course is power electronics and power systems. This is going to be the top course for electrical students after IISc. So you can be called for exam and interview from 450 to towards 999. But the majority of the students who got seat in IIT Bombay last 5 years, is the score is around 550 to 700. But don't think if you get 550, you will get seat, because there is a catch in this, because that scores may be towards a reservation also. and electronic systems. This is as such not from electrical background. This electronic systems course is offered by electrical department, but majority of the seats are for ECE students. I think one or two seats for the electrical department. So this is more of embedded systems, you can say, how to interface in real world hardware with microelectronics or with microcontroller or maybe DSP controller. So this will be, for us, we will give less criteria, less weightage for this course as an electrical engineer. So they'll call for interview from 550 to 600, but the range of students who have got selected for this, it is above 700 and 750, because there is a huge competition for this one or two seats. And energy systems, it is a more of interdisciplinary course in IIT Bombay. So more or less majority of the people will be around 500 to 550 score will be selected. But again, in these two also, we are not going to have 100% participation from electrical department. It is only one or two seats. That's it. And so this is the trend for IIT Delhi and IIT Madras. These are all, most of the numbers which are displayed here are for general category. Remember, it is not for any reserve candidates, because it is, your score is well above this one, then there is no issue. IIT Delhi, mostly it will offer control and automation, power electronics and electrical machines. This is the one course in IIT Delhi, and power systems is a separate course in IIT Delhi. These 700 and above will be the good criteria for IIT Delhi. The what my experience in IIT Delhi is, the interview is going to be very tough. You have to be very proper basics and proper identification of your subjects, because most of electrical engineering students who got this course above 750 have general tendency to apply for ECE courses, but don't go for that one. That is my suggestion, humble request and suggestion from my side, because we are not in, our way of education in electrical engineering is not intended for those subjects. And I will go as per the course and the what we are going to have in industry. That matching is there. Just IIT Madras, we have only two courses, control and instrumentation. It, IIT Madras is a very highly high score people only going to IIT Madras. That is, they will call for interview from 500, but general tendency there is 700 to 780. Power electronics and power systems, that is going to be the 700 to 750. So all other IITs will also follow the same criteria, but only thing is they will call more people for the interview and test. So NITs will be further low, but they will be on par. If you compare NIT Warangal, NIT Tiruchi, all are on par with almost all IITs. So next, coming to courses. So as an electrical engineer, we are more towards electrical machines and drives. In our blood, we are going to have electrical machines is our core subject. And power systems, it is also same, similar fashion. But coming to power electronics, you will not feel power electronics is our subject as such. But that is not true. power electronics is our core subject, because I will explain where it is going to be. And embedded systems, again, it will also come under ECE background students. That's how we will think, but that is not true. And electronics systems and electronic design, so that is also going to be the electronics. But the thing is, all these five areas or five courses are from electrical engineering. I am not giving microelectronics or nanoelectronics, because that is too much deep into the electronics. But where you are going to be placed, because when you go for M.Tech or when you go for PhD, our target is to be settled in very good job. Which are all companies will offer what kind of roles and what is the package closed range. If you want to select power system as a career, so in our country we have BHEL, NTPC, Power Grid Corporation, and majority of steel and oil companies will offer trainee engineer or graduate trainee engineer. These are the companies, and the package is going to be very, very good. It is more than close to more than 12 lakhs. One advantage you are going to see when you join in public sector company is you are going to be very well placed and your facilities are very good. And the drawback what I see is, once you go there, before joining, what you will think is, I will do IAS or maybe I will prepare for IAS. But when once you are there in that position, then your thinking and the mind will change. So you are not interested to do all those things. But coming to private sector company, which are all we are going to learn in this power systems course. In power systems course, we are going to learn high voltage DC transmission, FACTS, flexible AC transmission systems, and complete microgrid, solar panels, all energy based systems we are going to learn, which are all companies working in this domain. Is first one is ABB. So sure shot, you are going to be placed in ABB if you are interested more in power system and towards the flexible AC transmission as well as the microgrid or static converter. Siemens is the one more company which they are almost aligned with ABB. They will also mostly working on microgrids, how the system is going. And GE, because this is a most favorite company for all electrical engineers, because that's what that GE imagination at work is. Because this is going to be the favorite company for all the people. And apart from these two, three, which are all there, Alstom, what they will work is, they will be a transportation. Maybe you have seen metro, all major cities, the metro is going on, so that we are going to have more and more jobs. And most of the contracts are given to Alstom or maybe Siemens or maybe ABB or Bombardier. So Bombardier is also one more company which is working in power system as a transportation company as well as aerospace. That logo specifies aerospace as well as the transportation. This is one side of power system. When you go to power systems on other side, to take any system, any combined entity, to take laptop, because there power electronics engineer will work only one module, but power system engineer, they will call it as, not call it as a power system engineer, they will call it as a power delivery engineer, who will work on all the complete integration. that this power system, it is very difficult to restrict within a box. So that's why I listed only traditional power system companies which are offering jobs. And what about salary range? When you take the average salary from all NITs and IITs, they will offer around 8 to 9 lakhs for the fresher. So maybe you are thinking PSUs will be more salary range as compared to private sector. But private sector, only first 3 years you are going to be less as compared to public sector. But after 3 years you are going to be the expert and your salary range nowhere comparable to your PSU colleague. That is my personal experience. When you take power electronics as a career, where you are going to be placed? There are many startups everywhere, almost in each and every major city, many startups are started as a power electronics. So these are the some of the companies, maybe see this: Qualcomm, Intel, Samsung, Texas Instruments, GE and Cisco, and GM, Toyota, and Nissan, Honda, Volkswagen, Mercedes-Benz. Why this power electronics is needed? Because in nowadays, it is not possible to live without power electronics application from starting to ending of your day. So usually we'll start with mobile, by seeing mobile or maybe TV or maybe opening laptop, all are having power electronics. So this is also one more classic way of defining it is not possible to restrict within a box. So how this works in all these companies? Because you take all these first 4 companies, they are on the top most salary range of a technical company: Qualcomm, Intel, Samsung, Texas Instruments, Apple, Huawei, and Oppo or Vivo, Xiaomi, and FIH, and TSMC. All are needed power electronics engineers. So what is the salary range in these companies? The salary range for these companies will be around 11 to 12 lakhs for a fresher. I will explain you just before 4:30. I just had an interview with one person. He is from a consultancy. How much my company is paying for that consultancy is 5,000 per day is the minimum, 8,000 per day is going to be the maximum. You take 8,000 bracket. How many days in a month? It is close to 5 days per week and 22 days maximum. 22 into 8, it will be close to 1.7 lakh. The company is paying 1.7 lakh per month to the consultancy. But how much consultancy is paying to the candidate? It will be very close to 40,000 or 50,000. So if you join in this company as a full-time employee, all this 1.6 lakh will come to your hand. So these are the companies. Why I am focusing only on power electronics? This is the area where most of the research is going on. Now we are seeing why we are not seeing a mobile, and even though we are seeing a mobile, why it is very bulky, even laptop or desktop. Why it is bulky? Because the components, the electronics components inside the laptop is bulky. Why the process is not changed? Then what is the research going in power electronics is, now we are using MOSFETs. Maybe in next coming years, gallium nitride. And next, after 20 years, or maybe after 10 years, it is going to be a silicon carbide. It is going to be evolving, evolving, evolving. What are the applications of the real power electronics? We may see EV, DC-DC converter, battery charging, maybe LED drivers, LED lighting. All those companies will come under power electronics. Embedded system. So embedded systems, we will think this is not our subject, but strictly speaking, this is the basic subject every electrical student must have. Because here you are not doing anything, it is not related to electronics or it is not related to electrical. So just it is related to some coding, maybe C language, assembly or C++. So where you are going to be placed if you are an embedded engineer? All these companies, maybe you are thinking Intel, Samsung, Texas Instruments, maybe NXP Semiconductor, TCM as a Qualcomm now. So why I written same companies as a previous? So previous one, and if I go to previous one, here also Qualcomm is there. Qualcomm, we know Qualcomm Snapdragon. That is a mind of a human being. You consider it is a mind of human being. But what is a heart? Heart is going to be the power management IC, which drives this Snapdragon processor. Even that is true with Intel process inside. What is Intel inside? There is a processor, Intel i3 processor, i5, i7. That is going to be the heart. So that is going to be the mind which runs all the functions. But what is the brain? What is the heart behind that one? It is a PMIC buck converter of close to 50 amperes current. And even all the companies I have listed, that is maybe you are thinking. Here, all these companies are present in power electronics career as well as embedded systems, because the focus is different here. In this case, Qualcomm is a PMIC, Intel is also a PMIC as well as the DC-DC converters. Samsung, we know all the refrigerators, TVs and AC, all are going to work with power electronics. Texas Instruments also similar. When you come to embedded systems, the focus is completely different here. What NXP Semiconductors, which is same as Qualcomm now, it is a most of automotive focus. It may be we are using a door. So door closing microcontroller, door opening microcontroller, ECUs, everything. Everything is going to be a microcontroller based now. Intel, maybe you are confused why Intel is present here. The Intel bought Mobileye, which is a autonomous car company, and Samsung bought Harman, which is a one more automotive company. Texas Instruments, it is also a automotive microcontroller. So Toyota and BMW, because most you take most of the consultancy firms which are there in India, Infosys, TCS, Wipro. Close to 30% of their revenue comes from automotive companies. Why these automotive companies are very, very important? Because they will do outsource. They will do outsourcing for the Indian company. Most of the embedded system jobs are in automotive. So as I mentioned, the salary range is going to be little less as compared to power electronics as during starting when you placed in automotive company. It is close to 10 lakhs. So what is the latest trend? Maybe you are heard of Internet of Things. Maybe we are seeing V.AI saying that first internet IoT enabled water heater, IoT enabled AC. This is going to be the big trend in coming years. What is the one more? Connected vehicles. All these companies are working in connected zone because that is going to be the next thing. And what is the one more? Electric vehicle zone. So electric vehicle, we are going to see all mechanical engineers, electrical engineers and drives, everything, power electronics, battery systems, chemical engineers. And next one is a drone. So you know drone what purpose. So that's how these all features, all these are going to be very good for electrical engineers. And one more thing is, if you want to be placed in latest trend like IoT, IEEE connected vehicles or drones, there are two separate channels for electrical engineers. One is embedded hardware engineer. Other one is embedded software engineer. The embedded hardware engineer, he will focus only on how to select a component, on where to place, how to do the PCB, and which is the most appropriate layout to pass EMI standard, those things. Embedded software engineer or firmware engineer, who will be writing the code for this embedded hardware. And maybe there may be a lot of challenges because of PCB may be not correct, or maybe some component may be working wrongly. So drones also, it is going to be combined. It is a complete electrical system. So take electrical motors are there, power electronics is there, battery is there, everywhere. Almost it is a complete electrical system. Now you are doing it. And all these applications, IoT, a drone, or a mobile, or a laptop, are battery-based applications. So all these latest trends will give you more salary, and again, there is a one risk in this. There may be chances of layoff, because it is the latest trend. If it picks, you are going to be at infinite. If it is not, then you are going to be at ground level. So that is from my side, my choice for the courses for electrical engineers is these five. Power systems, which is a much more old course which is available for electrical. Electrical machines and drives, because this is going to be the one of the booming trend now because of electric vehicles and drones. Power electronics, it is a evergreen hot course in electrical department. And embedded systems and electronic design. As such, if you are in power electronics domain, you should learn this embedded systems. Anyway, electronics design is going to be the complementary for power electronics. So that much from my side. Any questions? Hello. Any question? first two slides. Okay. So these are the courses available in IIT Bombay. One is Control and Computing, Power Electronics and Power Systems, Electronic Systems, Energy Systems, Control and Instrumentation. Whatever the numbers which are mentioned here for the general category and which it is on an average of average of people who got selected in all these courses. And Control and Computing, Power Electronics and Power Systems, and Electronic Systems are from Electrical Department course, and Energy Systems is a separate department here, and Control and Instrumentation is going to be the separate department in IIT Bombay. And these are the things from IIT Delhi. IIT Delhi Electrical Department offers Control and Automation, Power Electronics and Electrical Machines and Drives is a one course, and Power System. One beauty in IIT Delhi is if you go for one interview, remaining two interviews you can attend at the same day. No need to wait for that. The gate cutoff is going to be close to 550 majority of the courses, but the people who got selected and who got seat in IIT Delhi will be around 700 to 750 for Control and Automation, 750 to 850 in Power Electronics, and Power System 750 to 800. And IIT Madras, they have only two courses for a Electrical Department, that is Control and Instrumentation and Power Electronics and Power System. Suppose you are getting less score, don't worry, there are many institutes who are offering based on the gate score. One is one university based on one university which is by ISRO, that they will also offer the MTech based on gate score. And one more university is also there by DRDO, and they will also offer based on gate score. Any questions? These numbers are for general category only. Cutoff will be close to 450 to 500. IIT Bombay. If you want this presentation, just contact Monu. Any questions? Any further questions? So NIT, basically NIT also offers the same courses. There is no differentiation between the courses offered by IIT as well as NIT. But only thing is, you choose good NIT in such a way that the course structure as well as the curriculum is good, because the main focus is going to be the power electronics and power systems and control. You go through the curriculum offered by NIT for the course and what you are going to learn from that course and how it is going to be helpful for your job. That's how you are going to select a course. You take power electronics and power systems in IIT Bombay. What are all courses I did is first semester, first course is a power systems, power electronics one, that is the basics, and microprocessor applications in power electronics, that is nothing but a DSP applications in power electronics. That is a very good course. And power electronics lab, and one more is electrical machines. That is the first semester. Second semester, electrical machine modeling and fax devices and power electronics 2 and the power electronic simulation tools, and one more course, VLSI design and VHDL course. And third semester and fourth semester, it is supposed to be mostly project. All these courses, 10 or 11 courses, are going to be very useful. That's how you have to choose which curriculum they are going to offer. What courses in that curriculum will be very good for you. So how to choose that one? Because sometimes you may have to go to some other department for different course. Then in that case, whether it is going to be good for your career or not. Because one course we did is a power semiconductor
development. Formula book mat enrollment ERP ma karvu
hoy to? As such, the course is not going to be there in a
product
electrical.
So, एक student ने
any further question?
Online ही formula book खरीदी ना दे सकतो. You can query मने जागरूक ही लेने.
Any question?
So, in a matter of time.
Any question?
So, एक mail ना थे शिबा ने कि भाई अगर इतना बार थी कोई निकाल मतलब बुक खरीद लियो तो खरीद इसे क्या ना setting कर दो क्या रे चलने कर दो.
हाँ ना. MIT MBA. MIT.
हाँ अगर student सिवाय भी कोई भी जाने हैं non IT ने खरीद
लिया. Yeah, but project management.
हाँ sir.
As such, when you go join in a at least for MBA course. When you join in a good company as a project management, there is no issue.
But the thing is,
where you are going to be placed, in which domain, finance or project management.
ये
आपने
जाकर
ईआरपी
हैंडल करे
कंसेप्ट वाला नहीं पता एचआर
डिपार्टमेंट
यहाँ पे यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू डू एनी टेक्निकल वर्क सपोज वन प्रोग्राम इज गोइंग टू बी देयर यू आर गोइंग टू बी सेलेक्टेड एज अ प्रोग्राम मैनेजर एंड व्हाट आर ऑल थिंग्स हैपनिंग यू आर गोइंग टू मॉनिटर But if you are really interested in managing the people, then that is good. MBA. But if you are
a
technical person, then I don't tell you to go for project management.
Okay.
Any doubts?
બધું જો આવશે તો કરાઈ દેશું કન્સેપ્ટમાં એટલે ત્યાં સુધી તમે બધું મોકલીને તો રાખો હા એટલે રેડી તો રહે હા પાડે તો એ બધું ધબાધબી થાય તો છે અને હા તમે કઈ જેમિન મેં તમને કોલ એટલે કહ્યું હતું કે તમે જેમિન સર ને કઈ કોલ કર્યો હતો કઈ ડેટા કે કઈ જોઈએ છે તમારે હા શેના માટે બોલો
Any question?
Oh. તો કે જ ને કેમ કે આના અહીંયા પાછળથી બધા જ લોકો જબરદસ્ત મહેનત કરી રહ્યા હોય ને સેન્ટર થી સ્ટુડન્ટ ઇન્વોલ્વમેન્ટ નું તો સર તો ઉત્સાહ જ ને એટલે કન્ફ્યુઝ છે. એટલે અત્યારે મને કીધું, મેં કીધું એટલે કે મને સર બધો ડેટા માંગે છે વોટ્સએપ નો. મેં કીધું તું કયા સર, તો કે અંકિત સર ને. એટલે મેં અંકિત સર ને ફોન કર્યો. મેં કીધું સર તમારે ડેટા કઈ રીતનો જોઈએ, એટલે હું એ પ્રમાણે યુસેજ માં આપું. એટલે તમારે એટલે મેં તમને ફોન કર્યો. પછી કન્ફ્યુઝ થયો બિચારો મને કે આ નંબર, મેં કીધું આ નંબર છે અંકુર સર, તો ઈ તો સુરત. મેં કીધું ના, ઈ વડોદરા રિજનલ મેનેજર આવ્યા હતા ને ઈ. મેં કીધું
If you don't have any further questions, then you can stop.